my world. Won't you come on in? Miracles, I guess, still happen now and then. Step into my heart, leave your cares behind. Welcome to my world, built with you in mind. Knock and the door will open.
That was a very interesting song. I remember hearing that years ago. And when I received an email today from a wonderful gentleman, I'm not going to mention the name of the channel, this song popped into my head, actually. Welcome to my world. And as the world turns, remember, soap opera. Well, this is not a soap opera. What I'm about to give to you, as far as what's going on with this channel and this particular platform and Google. Yeah. And this is not only affecting me, but a lot of other channels. Revelation Station. Joseph, Daily Excellence, Anthony, dealing with Council of Time, and would you believe what I'm going to show you when we get to my part of this video and the channel, how many videos I have to take down. And of course, we know there's a war on, you know, us. And I spoke about this almost a month and a half ago, I believe, that this channel is fixing to make some changes. And today, I got that validation with confirmation. Today. Okay. And a lot of people has questions, and I'm going to answer most of your questions in this video. Dealing with Patreon and this and this and that. So I'm going to cover that. I'm going to take you to a channel here on YouTube. And when you watch that video, it'll have the channel logo right there, the name of it. Also on Rumble. The link will be in the description box for Revelation Station. He's moving some of his videos to Rumble. I'm moving mine to Patreon and Brighteon. Okay, I'm bringing Brighteon back. I will explain in a few minutes. about people that have problems with their debit card, credit cards, or out of the country. Okay? And they want to go to Patreon. But for some reason, Patreon has it set up that if it's a vault, private, and you have to use your credit or debit card, set up an email address, but for some reason it's not working for the people in the UK. I don't know about Australia. Chances are outside this country. I don't even know if Canada can get in. So if it's anybody from Canada that's on Patreon, let me know. So it's getting worse. As some of you know, when I did the update, what was going on with the channel, I've done that many times, and this is another time. This next video clip is going to explain, and I even talked about this months ago. It's called the Disinformation Act that this government put up. It's a new government agency, actually, and their job is to remove any channels or anyone on public forums, social media, that's spreading disinformation. Everything I have put up has been validated with confirmation on this channel, every single one. But now it's not good enough. They're coming after everyone. So here we go. Listen up.
Well, Google is expanding its disinformation campaign in Germany and India because the one they did in Poland, they thought was really successful. They are literally calling this inoculation. They are inoculating you and users from misinformation. Now, like other things that you use for inoculation, we can consider it a information vaccine, right? It makes you more able to cope with misinformation. It doesn't stop the spread of misinformation. It just makes you less susceptible to it. You see what I did there?
Oh, I see.
But they are using these words, not me. They literally call it their inoculation campaign. These are videos that Google produces, and they run on Facebook. So Facebook's in bed with this too. YouTube and TikTok. Google makes them to counter information that it does not like. Information about what? Well, according to the Associated Press, topics include COVID, immigration, climate change, elections. So I thought here, if I give you this little quiz here. Now, Google says they started with this test pilot. So look at this option here. What subject amongst these subjects do you think that they started with? Given these options, what do you think they started a misinformation test campaign with?
Google pre-bunking.
Distrust in democratic institutions.
Okay. That's your vote, Phil.
That would have been my vote, too. That would have been my vote, is distrust in democratic institutions.
Okay.
I'm going to go with climate change.
Okay, you're all wrong. If you answered, let's see if anybody in the chat, can you just...
Yeah.
No, okay. If you answered Ukraine, you would be correct. Google started this very important problem of disinformation to align itself with NATO war narratives. Oh, interestingly okay. enough. I mean, they could have started with any dangerous narrative in the world. They could have started with childhood obesity. They could start by helping elderly people learn to identify online scams. Wouldn't that be something? Like, right. Google is actually going to help you not get scammed. By scammers and social security scammers.
Right, like if you got an email, like grandma got an email and it was like, Social Security, we're gonna give you more in your Social Security check. Click here.
Like, grandma, don't do that.
Any of those things.
Yeah.
You notice from this list that the only topics on the list of things they want to counter about misinformation are topics that will either give governments or corporations more power if you do not question
them. I have a question about
that,
though.
That's something I want to...
Does that...
Philip first, and then David.
Yes.
Go ahead. Okay. So that was what I was going to point out here was where it says there at the bottom, like the authoritarian propaganda and distrust in democratic institutions. What that's saying is basically like anything put out by people we don't like, then we want to, that's disinformation. So if it's authoritarian propaganda, but what about like democratic institution propaganda? That's actually something they're going to be doing for them.
Yes.
So they're actually going to be producing propaganda for the democratic institutions they like while like stifling authoritarian propaganda. I mean, it's interesting. They're like just basically saying, we're going to get in bed with these guys right now. And we'll just make their own propaganda for them because
that's what it feels
that's
like.
What they're saying.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, and my question is, does that mean they're going to open up so that if I search something, I get all the results? I just get told which one is propaganda? Or are they going to continue to do what they already do? Because you can't find information that's valid on any of that stuff already. So it's like it's already been.
Let's take a look at how they do it, how they're inoculating you. And we'll see if that, I don't think that really answers your question, but we'll see. Again, you know, none of these things on this list are about anything that would do anyone like really be good for humanity. It's only good for corporate interest. Like normalize not drinking, right? That would be a nice one. Or stop feeding children too much sugar. Be kind to all people based on their skin color, not based on their skin color.
Focus on who you are, not what.
Right. Like inclusive humanity, you know, those kind of things. Yeah, I guess like, sure, there's a lot of misinformation there about alcohol and food and sugar and education. And I was just listening to an Honestly podcast about misinformation about how children learn to read and how these women got super rich in the 80s and 90s, drove Maseratis by peddling this reading program that actually was completely ineffective and children did not learn to read. And like, those are things that absolutely we could use some misinformation, aid about, but that's not what we're doing. So I think this makes it clear that the corporate idea of disinformation is really only related to corporate and government interest, not at all in human interest, or else they would use it differently. So let's take a look at how they applied this to a problem in Ukraine. This is a pre-bunk video that I thought was very successful. Remember, they ran this in Poland, so it is in Polish, and there are subtitles.
Wojna w Ukrainie trwa nie tylko w terenie, ale także w twoim telefonie. Żeby wygrać tę wojnę, niektórzy będą próbować tobą manipulować, robiąc z Ukraińców kozła ofiarnego i winiąc ich za twoje problemy.
Hej, wszystko gra?
Pytam, jak ci idzie szukanie mieszkania.
Przez tych Ukraińców nie mogę znaleźć mieszkania.
Co?
Polacy nie mają gdzie mieszkać. Rząd zabiera nam mieszkanie i rozdaje za darmo Ukraińcom.
Uważasz, że to wina Ukraińców? Nie rób z nich kozła ofiarnego.
Kozła ofiarnego?
No, nie zwalaj wszystkich swoich problemów i nieszczęść na innych. To absurd. Sprawdzałeś, kto to napisał? Co to w ogóle za strona?
Co to za różnica? Po co ktoś ma mnie oszukiwać?
Na przykład, żeby odwrócić twoją uwagę. Żebyś obwiniał uchodźców za wszystkie swoje problemy, zamiast skupić się na wojnie, która ich tutaj sprowadziła.
Jeśli ktoś twierdzi, że złożone problemy są winą konkretnej osoby czy grupy, to może być manipulacja. Kozioł ofiarny to jedna z najczęściej używanych technik szerzenia dezinformacji. Nie daj się manipulować.
Wow. Okej. Okay. So I think the spirit of this is fine. You shouldn't reduce your problems to any one group of people. Mm-hmm. They are also telling us, though, not to blame anything on refugee problems when there are, in fact, refugee problems in the world. In many places.
In Poland, I mean, Poland is under the weight of 5 million refugees.
Yes.
Like
it's a valid question to ask, how will Poland survive an influx of refugees? That is not represented in this video. You know, we have shown you the research showing that there is a refugee problem in Poland. You shouldn't feel hateful and grumbly like this dude about it, right? But listening to Google tell you to go brush those questions aside doesn't solve any problems either. Like, right. How is the Western world supposed to meaningfully absorb immigrants from all war-torn places, not just Ukraine?
Right.
How will countries continue to provide for Ukraine? How will we make sure that Ukrainians are not getting special treatment above immigrants from other countries that are also suffering and in line at refugee programs? What kind of Ukrainians that could not immigrate and had to stay, that couldn't leave Ukraine and had to stay there and fight a war they don't want? What about those people, right? These are all valid questions, and Google's basically telling you, knock that off and be the kind of person who sits casually in a cafe, please.
Just be a neutral person. Go on antidepressants so you don't feel one way or the other. You're not too volatile and you're not too down here. Just be steady Eddie. Just in simple Google search results. That's what they want.
Right. And
stupid,
so
critical thinkers.
Yeah.
Right.
My question. Sorry.
Yeah.
My question would be like, I wonder if we'll see anything from Google that's like pro-labor union to inoculate people so they're not against unions. You know that they would be quiet on that one.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. And someone in the chat says 1.5 million refugees, Clayton, not 5 million. No, we've talked to sources in Poland. who said it could even be higher than 5 million. So that's even being conservative. Those are numbers that come from sources we've had here on the show specifically, but maybe those numbers change, you know, the government's not coming out with official numbers anyway, sorry.
Well, this is a project from Jigsaw, which is a branch of Google that's working on this. And they said that negative stories about refugees have real world impacts because there's been 65 attacks on refugee shelters in Germany alone, which is not nothing, but imagine throwing all the weight of Google to solve a problem in the world for something that's happened 65 times. Of course, that shouldn't be happening, but there's child trafficking in the world that they could be trying to solve, right? But not just something that's like happened 65 times in Germany. Abuse of other groups happens much higher incidence. Like all of this money in towards this problem, you would almost think that they were doing this to get us to support the NATO side of the war. Here is where they ran these ads as a test. You can see Poland, Czech and Slovakia on Facebook and Twitter. After these users saw these ads, they gave them a survey containing 1 to 3 questions to determine if the ads afterwards, they could better identify fear-mongering and scapegoating. This is how they gave us those metrics. They didn't show us the survey, and this is not a peer-reviewed study, so I can't vouch for whether or not the questions they asked these people after seeing the ads were valid or reliable, but they think they were, so I'm sure they were, right?
Yeah,
that's sarcasm. Sure. But they showed that it could help these small percentages like feel differently after online tutorials. So what's next now? What are they going to do? Well, more. They say that they're moving new pre-bunking experiments in India and Germany with local partners and experts. Now, I wonder what disinformation they seem to think is necessary in those regions and who gets to decide. Here is one pre-bunking experiment they're working on, anti-vaccine narratives. So my question is, who's partnering with them about this? Someone that may have a vested interest? I don't know.
Will Pfizer, Moderna have anything to do with this?
Now, the Associated Press says, I didn't see this in Google's information, but this was in the AP story about it, that the effects of these videos, of these inoculation videos, wears off. Like you might think critically for a while and then you forget.
Like a vaccine.
Like core training.
Like the COVID vaccine. It wears off after.
Yes. And so they need boosters. What?
I want to see if I understand this correctly. Like basically, what you're talking about is that you're talking about like change people's like core beliefs. Like they're aiming at your core beliefs. They're aiming at your morals and like your like entire world paradigm. And they think that if that changes, it just kind of reverts back.
Yeah.
Like, that blows my mind. Like,
an exercise.
Maybe I work differently than the people yeah.
Yeah. So they're thinking that you need boosters, booster videos. They use this term. I guess they think that we have a positive connotation with it these days. But they think they need to do booster pre-bunking videos to keep users sharp, which is funny. Because, you know, pre-bunking inoculation with boosters, these are words I increasingly do not want to hear.
Right.
But the question remains, why is Google doing this? They have not been a moral authority, at least not in their inception. They were a ranking information. That's all they did. I mean, we know they do a lot more, but now they're promoting narratives.
They're doing it for money. They want Google to be what they see as a safe place for advertisers, right? So it's the same reason that they block us on YouTube. They, you know, shadow ban channels. They can make plenty of money off of our channel through advertising, but they push down because they want to make this platform and Google like an advertiser friendly place. And so if Pfizer, Moderna, and all of these companies can continue to funnel them all sorts of billions of dollars in advertising revenue for their pharmaceuticals and everything, then it's a safe environment for Google. Imagine if Pfizer execs are sitting there and they're thinking about where to put their ad dollars.
Yeah.
And they start seeing Google search results that are like Pfizer this, Pfizer that, Moderna this. They downrank all of this stuff to push that stuff away, and they continue to make their good ad revenue.
But now they don't even have to produce ads anymore because Google is essentially doing it for them. So right. Imagine what a pre-bunking video would look like around a COVID vaccine. You right. know, you'd see some grumbly dude with a dark hat like that guy. Like, oh, you know, these things, I'm not going to take them because my uncle said Bill Gates, blah, blah, blah. Right.
Right.
I can't even repeat some of the narratives here.
So like what the thing is, like, this is just like in such short, it hasn't been all that long ago. What, like a couple of weeks since the Davos had that brain transparency,
yeah.
you know, seminar where they're like, this is all exactly what they were talking about at Davos. It was like that yeah. brain transfer. Well, this is, like basically like we need to get into people's brains.
Yeah.
Because I feel them. Like they know that they are losing the information war, and now they're going to have to go outside of us going to them. Because lately, like recently, it's us going to them to search for information, but we have found ourselves. You can't find good information there. So the people that are not going on are looking outside of Google. So now they have to find ways to win the information war by going outside of that with marketing campaigns to pull us back into their narrative. They're losing us.
Yeah.
That's what I see.
Yeah. I mean, you've seen this too with cable news. And of course you're seeing with the mainstream media, and they're having to just, I don't know. It's a losing battle because independent media continues to rise, the rise of Rumble and so forth, and rise of alternative video platforms. They're going to keep getting stronger and keep getting stronger, adding new users and adding new users. You saw what happened to Facebook. I mean, that whole population is being aged out on Facebook, right? Like
yeah.
there's no new users, although they said there were, but I don't buy that for a second. New people aren't coming into Facebook. Like, who's today deciding to wake up a young person? Like my son's like, you know, Dad, can you help me set up one of them Facebook accounts?
No.
No, could you imagine?
If you were getting new users, you wouldn't be laying off 14,000 people. You wouldn't be losing thousands of people at your yeah. place if you were doing better.
I know when they had their most recent, Facebook had their most recent earnings call, and they said they added all sorts of new users. I was like, what? After a quarter where they announced they had their first round of like huge decline in users and no new, like where are these new users suddenly coming from? It all sounded fake to me. In order yeah. to prop up a stock, like I don't know. So I think you're right about this. I think that there's like, I don't know. They're trying to make it nicer, but it's a losing battle because eventually people are going to turn off, you know, turn away from Google fully and go to other services, like they are on, you know, YouTube, but finally starting to move towards Rumble and other platforms.
Yeah, I like Lyndon Watson in the chat calls this IQ blockers. That's a good one.
Yeah.
All right, you have the last word on that. Thanks so much.
Alternative platforms. Sounds like the two I belong to. Patreon. Brighteon. I tried Rumble. Only a few people went over there, so I'm not doing that again. Okay. I'm going to be on Brighteon and Patreon. And this channel has never been monetized. I will not allow them to put up advertisements or commercials. I have got more than 20 emails of companies that wanted to monetize this channel, and I decided not to do it years ago. I'm not going to do it. I don't want advertisement to come up right in at a point of the video that is important, and then I have no control actually what they're promoting unless I stop and investigate what the advertisement is. So, this video right here, no more. Okay, Earth to God, no more. That's mine. Okay, that one's okay. This one, I explain what happened. This one right here, that's perfectly fine. That's the schedule. This one is no more. Okay. Thoughts on the time we have, that's mine. This one, no more. Have to remove that one. Mm-hmm, that's right. Okay, this one right here, I have to remove that as well. Okay, that's mine. Perfectly fine. I'm just showing you what's fixing to take place. Part two, that has to be removed. Okay. Right there. Okay. Those are okay. This was very controversial. That one's got to be removed. Okay. This one here, I got away with it, but on my backup channel for Christian Messages, it got taken down. That's got to be removed. That's okay. That's okay. Oh, part one. Did the Earth's core stop rotating? Oh, that's got to be removed. Okay. Uh-huh. Yeah. That one's okay. That's mine. All mine. So, I'm going to make some changes. And I'm going to talk about it in here just a moment. I just want to show you how many has to be removed. If that's okay with you. Because this channel has thousands and thousands of hours invested in videos and professional videos productions, as well as spiritual messages. The playlist is there. I already went through all of that. Okay. So the following videos have to be removed within 7 days. Okay, I'm going to get to all of that that was in that email. Just a moment, as much as I can, but I have to make a stand against all of this and fight the good fight for all of you. I'm not the only one doing it. There's other channels moving, and the reason I kept this up there so long at the beginning, not to bore you, okay, this is the Copyright Disclaimer Act, Section 107, 1976. Now you read what it says. Allowance is made for fair use for purpose such as criticism, comment, news reporting, like I did on the earthquake, teaching, scholarship, research. Fair use is a use permitted by copyright status that may otherwise be infringing non-profit, educational, or personal use tips the balance in favor of fair use. I have obeyed the community guidelines on this particular platform. Now, there was sometimes I pushed it to the edge, and I cut back on all of that. But now they're coming after me for every little thing that they can catch me on. You know why? I want to monetize. I won't be monetized for them. So now with this new AI system, you know what AI stands for, right? Artificial ignorance. Now I have to make decisions because I'm abiding their community guidelines. Even a person I put a song on, and example here, and they took it down. And the guy says, Jim, all you got to do is put all the copyright status and stuff in there. I did that. Okay. I even mentioned the name of the person who wrote the song, the artists, all of that, and who controls all of that as far as copyrights. And it seems like no matter what I do, it's never enough. So now I'm moving over here. Okay, I already told everybody you can get a membership. Just $1, 100 pennies, okay? The videos that I have over here that's got to be removed. Not on this platform. Okay, that one stays. Guess what? All of them stays. Yeah. That's my personal thoughts. Okay. Yeah, that's mine too. It got by the boob tube. You know, that's over there. When they blocked it worldwide. Part 4. It's over there. I got to take it down on YouTube. Today. Okay. I'm not going to wait 4 or 5 days. That one's got to be taken down. They're all over there. Even the one about the earthquake in Turkey that I have to take down. The apocalypse. Earthquakes. That one's right there, safe. But they took it down on Deep Truth. So I'm going to start focusing on that platform. I'm already starting some ideas for upcoming projects that I can't put up here. Also, you can go to Brighteon. Links in the description box. It'll take you directly to that page. Okay. But I'm thinking about changing the name back to Earth Changes Channel, but change it to Earth Changes News Channel. Sort of correspond with Patreon. That logo is going to be changed. Okay. 700 subscribers. Only 120. 200 went over there, I think. But the rest of them came from Brighteon. And all of this is over there. The real precursor. I could never put this up on this platform. All of these are excellent videos to get educated, and it's over there. About the strange document. The dark forces, the dark spirit forces against us, you know, the truth, it's hidden right before your eyes. Yeah, I can't say these words, you know, because of the artificial ignorance, AI, all of that's over there. You can go over and watch it. And then for people that live outside the country that can't get to Patreon, I'm going to put the videos up there a week later or 3 or 4 days later. It depends on how much time I got. Okay. And if you can't donate a dollar, we'll just wait a week and then you can go over there and see the latest videos. But all of these are over there. Almost 5,000 views. 4,000 views. That's pretty good on Brighteon to get that many views. But I'm going to have to do something. And I suggest you go there. Now, if I change the name, which I am, it may be a different link. I don't know yet. So this morning I received an email from a wonderful gentleman. I'm not going to mention his name. Unprofessional. And he told me that I gave me the list of the videos, said that YouTube's going to take them down and I will get 3 copyright strikes. Falls under community guidelines. 3 community guideline strikes. This channel is down. Okay, no more. And I went to this individual's channel, clicked on videos, of course, and I'll read it in the description box. He didn't have any copyrights. That was not posted. Okay. And if he did, I wouldn't have copied him. But he said he did. He had. But he was going to willfully, more than likely, let it go through on his end. But you too told him. No. If he doesn't take them down, we're going to take them down. In 7 days. So I got the email today, Tuesday. So what I have decided to do is the same thing I already did in the previous video dealing with this issue and issues. I do a spiritual message here Sunday. No more mic around the world on Monday anymore. That video is going to come down. And if I don't do something, they're going to take this channel down. And I'm not going to take a chance anymore. Okay? I'm not. So, when I do come back, it'll probably be a 15-minute video during the week. Point at the description box. Saying, if you want to receive this information, click here. That's it. Okay. That's it. I have to focus on these projects I've been wanting to do on Patreon. Now I'm moving forward on it. And I don't have to push the limit over there because it's free. Freedom of speech on those alternative platforms. To a certain point, I'm sure. I know a couple of them platforms are now removing certain videos. So that's kind of interesting. But I have not heard about Brighteon and Patreon. Those two are owned by Mike Adams. A wonderful gentleman, a patriot. He's doing his best to give people the freedom of speech. Because if we don't have freedom of speech, then what do we have, ladies and gentlemen? Okay? I think it would be a waste of my time to come back here with 30-minute and hour videos giving you pieces of candy. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to tell people what they want to hear. I don't do that. I tell people the evidence that they may not want to hear. And so far, this wonderful family has been taking it. Over there, rock candy. Something that lasts a long time. So, I might put up one a week if I have time. There's so much I have to do out here. I haven't even had time. You know, I have a life out here, ladies and gentlemen. Even though I'm out here by myself, I have a life. And tell you the truth, it's wonderful. Especially at night, looking at the stars and nice fire, and it's peaceful. So let's change, everyone. Please, let's do another change, okay? I'm sure some of you are asking, I wonder if he got mad, right? No, I didn't. That's right. I got disappointed. There's a difference from being angry, mad, and disappointed, isn't it? So, in the last video, what did I say? It's going to be a good fight, didn't I? Fight the good fight for Christ, didn't I? Mm-hmm. I knew this was coming months ago. 3 weeks ago, it got tighter. 2 weeks ago, it got tighter. And last week, it really got tight. And now, it's choking me. Unfortunately. And all of you are going to be affected by it because I can't give you the information here no more. Okay. How do you think I feel? That's a simple question, isn't it? It can be. To know the things I know, the research I have done, swirling around in my head, being a critical thinker, a mature soul. You know, sometimes it takes me 2 hours to go to sleep. If I'm lucky, I have to take melatonin. Then I wake up at 2 or 3 o'clock and have to take the melatonin again. Maybe some warm tea or something. I'm having difficulty sleeping. Some of you are as well. Because there's a lot going on. And for me to try to give you as much evidence I can possibly give to you, maybe you and your loved ones. So I have to make an adjustment. And if you want to remain a part of this family, you're going to have to make the adjustment too. And if you don't want to make the adjustment, that's okay. Sometimes people go to Brighteon and they don't get a notification. So when I come back and say a 10-15 minute video, hey, it's right there. There's going to be a Brighteon link for videos that come out over there. And there's going to be a Patreon link. But they're going to get it a week before Brighteon. Because I'm busy. I'm not going to transfer all this. But people don't understand. Every time you switch to a different platform, you have to upload that video. And sometimes it can take an hour. That's an extra time for me. If I can do it in the evening time, I will. When the stars come out. When the stars come out, I can do it. I'm doing everything I can for all of you. And I stated over 2 years ago, I will be here till the end. The wonderful family here, the subscribers that's been on this channel forever, they know that. But I never made a statement that I will be on this platform forever till the end. I did not. So, if you can't make a move, then just stay here. Get your piece of candy. It's a beautiful Sunday message. But you can go to Brighteon for free. It won't cost you 100 pennies. It won't cost you anything. I have to separate the two channels to keep the trolls out. It's a vault. Private. So I'm going to keep things private as much as possible. Brighteon. You want to go over there, be over there. You know, I'm going to try to keep that up as much as possible. As long as possible. But there's things that are happening, and you know it's happening, that basically it's important for me to let you know what's happening. That's my position. Okay? I'm going to tell you something. A lot of you new subscribers don't know. I was sent here as a messenger for you and everyone else that will listen to me. That's it. So I'm going to keep fighting the fight, because if I don't, my job as a messenger will come to a end, and I won't be on the unemployment line. I'll be preparing for my departure. I will have more time to myself, and I will miss everyone. Okay, I love all of you. You've been with me forever. Seems like it. And the new subscribers, they're so wonderful too. God bless you, all of you. So many wonderful comments. And I'm like, I haven't seen this person before, or this one, or this one, or this one. And then I'm being throttled back. When I did an update over a month and a half ago, you know how many views this channel received from an independent website that analyzes channels? 1.7 million views worldwide. Not what you can add up on all of those videos. The numbers don't add up. Try that one. So something's going up. The throttling me back. And the amount of subscribers I have is actually doubled. Talked about that too. A friend of mine knows someone that works for YouTube. And if a Christian channel goes out on the limb, it pushes the army lobe, they're going to be throttled back. They're not going to be promoted. They're not going to be in the search engine. It's going to show half the views and half of the subscribers. That's what's happening. 1.7 million views. So, if you put yourself in my position, you'll understand where I'm coming from, right? I believe so. You heard me say this before. I'm drawing the line in the sand. And I'm going to make a stand for all of you. That's what I do. You know what gets me? When I spend 6 hours on a professional video production, and the individual writes two words, thank you. I mean, really? That's it? Thank you. Oh, you're welcome. Okay, you're welcome. And then the times I have to go through 3 times a day to take the trash out on the comments, y'all don't see those messages. I monitor this channel every 3 to 4 hours, see how much trash I have to take out. And you know what? It's been quite a bit of trash lately, and I'm running out of garbage bags. You catch my drift, right? But I'm going to keep going. In fact, if I can get the chip, I'm going to change this computer where I can hold more storage, so I don't have to do more recording. Just have a library. That takes time. But my time will continue for you. My time will continue for me. I I got lucky last week. I saw one beautiful sunset that was totally amazing. Better than that aurora. What happened to the other six? Oh, I didn't catch them. You know why? I was on this computer recording for you. Not for me. I'm doing everything I can possibly do to help you all. It's not a game. It never was. When you put yourself out there, 1.7 million people watching your stuff. It's a big responsibility. You don't want to make any mistakes. Sometimes I do a video. I used to watch the whole thing before I uploaded it. Download. I hardly do that no more because I don't have the time. So, maybe a mistake here and there. I'm not perfect. I try to be a perfectionist. First time someone told me that, I'm like, I took it as an insult. But the person was absolutely correct. I am. I can't apologize about that. That's just the type of person I am. If that's okay with you. And I tell people like it is. Straight up. I don't put no sugar in my coffee. But lately I've been putting honey in there. How you like that? You know, I try to put humor into this, but I'm really not laughing. And this is probably more than likely, highly possible, to be my last personal message to a person that subscribes on this channel. More than likely, this is my last one. Dealing with issues. I'm tired of making updates on the channel, and you know, I've done made 3 in the last 4 weeks. I'm getting tired of it. So this is the last change. There's not going to be any more changes. No. I just want all of you to know that, and I love you all. And thank you for your prayers. I've been having sinus problems. Because of the trails of tears. People prayed for me. I want to say thank you. Took some rosemary. Put it on a Q-tip. Put it up in my nostrils. I'll tell you what, 30 minutes. My sinuses was cleaned out. So thank you. A little personal there, right? I'm sitting here looking at this screen recorder. And I got a lot running through my head right now. I'm going to try my best to end this message. Because it is a message. You just wait a few minutes. And I don't read a script, okay? I want people to know that. One guy says, man, that guy's reading a script. No, I ain't. No, I don't. I never do that. And I don't read from a website unless it involves a meteor or asteroid coming from spaceweather.com, and that's about it. Because I don't have to, okay? And I'm not going to mention any channels. I'm talking about this channel. And I'm channeling to you. How you like that? So now I have to end this message. We're going to change one last time. Okay. One last time. On this message. So here we go. You know, it seems that this is definitely the time for prayer right now. I talked about that on the previous video I have to take down today. And the other ones too. But they're not going to take you down. And they're not going to take me down. This is a time to fight the good fight. Isn't it? Not to get angry. You can get disappointed. Angry's different. So is anxiety. And I know a lot of you are going through that too. I stay away from that the best I can. Well, I didn't have an anxiety attack over this. I hope so much of you are getting through your personal issues. I really don't have any personal issues other than not spending enough time outside with nature. That's a big issue for me. This channel's been up for many years. Over 400 videos, actually. I had to delete about 70 of them because of this platform would have went back 6 months, a year, and 1, 2, 3 strikes, you're out. That's what they did to Terror Blackstar. Took him down, came back with a second channel, told everybody to go to Brighteon. And now, his channel is very successful over there. And I'm going to be successful over there. For you. As much as possible. I'm going to fight this good fight. And I'm going to, you know, I prayed on it this morning. Since I found out, when I had breakfast, I took a moment to pray on this, to pray for the children throughout the world that's innocent, pray for the homeless and those without food, water, shelter, clothing. You know who else is innocent? Our brothers and sisters that believe in Jesus Christ being persecuted all over the world. And I'm not going to say what they're doing to them or what they did to them. So this is a fight. And it is a good fight. And it's not a game. I'm very good at games. That's why I don't play them. I win 97% of the time. Interesting. And as I stated in that last video, this is not the time to play any games, to gamble with your soul. Not the time for that. Never was. Never will be. And this is not the time for the turning away either. If you're in door number two, you don't know what that door is, go back and watch the video. Turn it away. If you're in that door number two, you gotta get out. A lot of people take door number three. I took door number one. You know what's in that door? Prayer. is in that door. And the passing away, well, that's a lot. Passing away every day. This will continue on a higher level that's never been recorded before. So a lot of you are going to deal with that. I have not yet. More than likely I will. I don't know. It's only a few weeks left. How much time you got left, if you don't mind me asking? You gonna make it to the end? I'm gonna make it to the end. As long as Jesus Christ and the Heavenly Father and the Holy Spirit wants me here, I will be here. I want to be here when 3 days of darkness takes place, to validate my research and see the planetary system. That's pretty pathetic, isn't it? I believe so. I'm not going to be here. He's coming for his bride. And I'm a part of that, and so are you. Chances are. He's not going to abandon his bride before the wedding. That's unethical. And if you look at that metaphor, coming back for the bride, it's true for you and me. Very simple. It's not going to mentally and physically abuse the bride. The groom's not going to do that. Really? That doesn't make sense to me. What sense? You know what makes sense to me? That you're still here. And I wonder why. I'm talking about this channel. You're still here. And I'm here. And Jesus Christ is with us. He said, whenever two come together and speak of me, I shall be in their midst. He's with us right now. On the other side of the veil, the great veil. And guess what? That's fixing to be removed too. Scientifically, they're finding evidence that it could happen. Would you believe that? The magnetic field is weakening. The great veil is like a shell of protection from the spiritual realm and the material world. That's what that is. That's fixing to be removed. But you know what I'm going to say now? I love you all. I truly do. May the Holy Spirit fill your life. Prepare so we can go home. God bless everyone. Be safe. Continue in prayer. Much love to you and your loved ones. And thank you for being yourselves.